Welcome to Learners Academy. This is Mona Bhatia, and today's lecture is based on a subject of BMM second year, and the subject is mass media research. And today I'm going to cover the first chapter of this subject. In the first chapter, we are going to talk about relevance of mass media, scope of mass media research, and the role of research in the media. So first of all, let us understand why is it important. What is mass media research? As you all know, that a media which is something that impacts people's behavior, whether it is psychologically or behaviorally, it really has an impact on people. Whether you consider Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, television, telephone, newspaper, whatever may be the form of media, it really has an impact on people's behavior. Psychologically, it changes the behavior, and also behaviorally, it has an impact. Sometime you must have said yes to the internet prompt like Google Map, or you give rating on the net, and also Google asks you if it is okay to collect your browsing history so that they have a better understanding of your needs and they can better adapt to your choices of ads. So then when you are saying yes to those prompts, you are actually actively participating in mass media research. And why do they do that? The answer is because they want to increase their presence in your life. They want to impact your choices. All right. So mass media research is the study of information related to any form of mass communication. In older forms, we always had newspapers, radios, televisions, magazines. And with the onset of internet age, now we have all those new types of platforms which are available for us for doing the research, and they can be social media, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. All right. So now what do you think is the difference between old mass media research and the new? The answer is obvious. When we had old type of mass media researchers, they used to take a lot of time to get the information. Now the information is just on fingertips. Once you just press the button, the information directly goes to them, and that is now analyzed and they work on it. Earlier, it used to take a lot of time for conclusion and decisions to be made. Let us understand what is mass media. So a media which is able to reach to the masses is called mass media. For example, newspaper, television, all right, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. See, they all come under this category. All right, there are many, many other categories as well, which I'm going to, introduce to you. Now, why do people want to study mass media? Because you know why? Businesses, they want to target the audience for their advertisements. Now businesses, they want to know which form of mass media is producing better result, the best result. Okay, and they want to study the correlations. For example, they want to know the effect of violence on children. So once they get to know, they won't show such violence related things on their advertisements and all. So we can deduce the purpose of mass media research, that which is, it is for the benefit of public health. It also helps the businesses to figure out which form of advertisement will work and which will not work. They want to see the sales, all right? So all the businesses, they want to target this audience for better sales. So they want to see rise in the sales. So mass media research for businesses will focus more on the conversions. So if they are targeting certain audience, they want that thing to be converted into sales. So the number of people watching or reading a mass media and then turning into their customers, that's more important for them. For example, I can show you, like somebody is, you know, wants to advertise in a channel whose viewership is say 1 million every day. All right. So, but the ad that he the business wants to run is of only 30 minute seconds or 1 minute at the most per se. So the probability of the ads being watched is definitely less than 1 million, because 1 million is for one day, every day. So it is, say it is only 2000 people who watch that ad. All right. And then you will also look for the peak hours when the, you know, that program which is of high, you know, TRP, which is that program, which is the peak hour of that channel, right? So, and by the research, you have drawn a conclusion that when you run an ad, only 2% of the customers or the people who are watching your ad becomes the customer. So that means you will get 2000 into 2%. That means it comes out to be, okay, so it comes out to be 400. So now if you think that this figure of 400 is good to recoup the cost of the commercial and to provide profit, then you will decide to go ahead with the campaign. Otherwise, you may back out. So this is the idea why research plays a role, and it has an effect on the media. Now, next point is importance of mass media is that, look, businesses, they can also use mass media research to help them figure out how their potential customers look at the advertisements. All right, what they think of the online post and what do they think about their businesses. So mass media research for health is also done, and well-being is also very important for, okay, because of the technological revolution. What are the impact it is having on the society as a whole, both pros and cons also, okay? So for example, if you say use of smartphone, it has a negative impact also, and it has a positive impact as well. So a negative impact, you can say that increase or increase in of radiations when you are exposed to smartphone for a longer period of time, you are exposed to the radiations, and then you become socially aloof. That is also one negative impact of the smartphone. And what are the positive impact? Your work efficiency is increased, you are accessible, your sales may increase, you can have lot of entertainment on your fingertips, you can have lot of information on fingertips. So you have both the impacts, positive as well as negative. So what is a mass media? Today mass media is all very pervasive, you know, it's everywhere. It is a vital source of, you know, information. Mass media is nowadays, it's a key industry. It is also a source of employment, and it is also a source of economic profit. Mass media, it's a platform for so major social, political and economic debates. On a Facebook, if you see, on a Twitter also, if you see, there are a lot of, you know, trolls that happens, or somebody puts a point forward, and then there are people who, you know, either support that. So there are debates that happens on social media, and everybody is a participative person in that. All right. Now it is a main source of entertainment also. So that's the reason why we study, you know, mass media, and what do researchers exactly investigate in mass media. As I told you, I will tell you more about the different types of mass media, and here it is. You can see there are advertising, journalism, public relations, social media, audio media, film and television, photography. So they all come under the media. You can see the pictures over here. Analog media, billboard is also a form of mass media because information reaches to many people. And then cinema is also a form of mass media. News releases, dictaphone is also a mass media. Even your microphone, when you speak on a microphone and it reaches a lot of people. Copywriting, books are, they also come under this category. Then audio, outdoor media, films, letters, magazines, music, newspapers, notebook, photo media, snapshots. Even, snapshot, it gives information. Radio, publishers, publisher, paparazzi, even they provide you a lot of information. And then all those air channels, print media, shooting, television, video media, YouTube. So all of these things, they come under the category of mass media because they have that power to impact people psychologically as well as behaviorally, and they impact the decision making of the people also. People form opinion based on, which mass media they are following. All right. So before, getting into the definitions of research and before getting into mass media research, let us understand what is mass media. So mass media is any form of communication that reaches a large number of people. Okay, examples, what are the program people watch during dinner time, or are all the programs exceptionally great but not watched, or some program which are just mediocre but they have lot of people watching them. So here we can have a research or investigate why certain program is a hit and why others are a flop program. So what are the reason of its failure? So whenever we do research on all of these, why people like certain characters, even this can be a question of research. So topics which can be taken for research in mass media is anything under the sun. That is, there are unlimited number of topics that you can take for research in a mass media. So now what is a research basically? So according to Fred Curlinger, scientific research is a systematic, controlled and critical investigation of propositions about various phenomena. But according to Grinnell, research according to him is made of two words, that is re plus search. That means re means it's a prefix which is used to the word search. And what is the meaning of re? Re means doing it again, anew, over and over again. That means search which has been already done, but we are doing it again and again to find something extra, to examine, to probe, to test and try. So care, when we take all of these points in totality, we get to make a new definition, that is careful, systematic, patient study and investigation in some field of knowledge undertaken to establish facts or principle. So according to Grinnell, he termed the this definition for mass media, for research. So what is mass media research? It is unbiased. It should be unbiased. It should be structured, sequential method of inquiry directed towards a clear, implicit or explicit business objective. All right. So what is research? It is an attempt to discover something. And we all do this every day, knowingly or unknowingly. Research can be very informal without any steps or planning, which does not require any procedure. But lack of procedure does not mean that the research is wrong or incorrect. Okay. Now, it can also be formal. Formal means which follows a defined and exact procedures. So, but in the same way, use procedure does not mean that it is correct. So sometime when you are doing the things in a systematic manner may also be incorrect. And absence of steps and procedure does not mean that it is wrong. It can also lead to a good research. So, but whether it is formal or informal can be good or bad, correct or incorrect, right? So it basically depends on how the research is conducted. That is more important. Okay. Now, when we know that research is unbiased, structured, and sequential method of inquiry, so this inquiry will either it will lead to proving the existing theorems and model or arriving at new theories and models. All right. So the most important and difficult task for a researcher is to be objective, to be neutral as far as possible. Okay. And not even though the researcher might have a lot of knowledge about the topic, he should not deliberately try to get the result in the direction of hypothesis. Okay, that's very important for a researcher. So these are the three things that a researcher should always keep in his mind. He needs to be very objective. He needs to be very neutral. He should not try to deliberately get result in the direction of hypothesis. All right. Now, let us come to the main topic, which is mass media research. Here we are going to, we are going to cover three things, that is overview of research and ethics of research. All right. And major approach to research, which will also include qualitative research. What is qualitative? See, unlike quantitative research, which deals with the numbers and statistic, the qualitative research, it actually deals with ideas and experiences, okay, to gain understanding of reasons, opinions and motivations. Okay, then we are going to have content analysis, survey research or survey analysis, and longitudinal research. See, 5 year study of children who are exposed to social media, this is a long term, so it will come under longitudinal study, where the researchers will include environmental factors also and other factors as well. Next is experimental research. For example, effect of a new drug, say a vaccine of COVID vaccine, we can take this example on people having different health issues. Okay, this can come under this experimental research. Then we can have data analysis. What does that mean? What data was used to address the question and how did you do it? That can come under data analysis. So the next point, major approach to research can be research in the print and electronic media. So electronic media research fall in two categories, and they are rating and non-rating. Okay, so and there are two companies which conduct electronic media research, and they are one is AC Nielsen and the other one is the Arbitran company. Okay, so the last point here, major approach to the research is research on the internet. Nowadays, internet provides countless number of research possibility for mass media researchers, like internet-based questionnaires, like what makes a good website, how do people get attracted to your website. So the definition of research includes any gathering of data, any type of gathering of data, information and fact for the betterment of your existing knowledge. Okay, according to Wimmer research, research is the only area in mass media that relates to everything under the sun. So research is used in every position in mass media and it is everywhere. And if you plan to be a successful mass media researcher, you must understand the basics of research. Now, you ought to be a data analyst, and data analysts, they know how to understand and how to use statistics, and they also know how to interpret the results. Okay, you'll also need to know about statistic formulas and procedures. So research is an attempt to discover something, according to Wimmer and Dominic. Now, I may ask you a question, why research is so important in mass media? Because this can be, you know, answered by just thinking, why do people choose one program over another? Or how much time do they spend watching that program? How internet has affected other medias like newspaper, TV and radio? So why some advertising campaigns are successful while other they flop? So always you keep in your mind who, why, how, what. So these are certain questions. So every time you have these questions popping in your mind, you have raised a question that needs to be investigated, that needs to be researched. That could be your topic of research. So always keep in your mind five wives and a husband. What are the wives? Wives means anything that starts with W, who, what, when, where and why. And how, H is a husband, that is how. Okay, so you always keep these things in your mind and then you have a research question ready. So mass media research, it deals with the production of programs and the consumption of audience. So there is not any area in mass media that does not conduct or use research. That means research is the only area in mass media that relates to everything, as I told you. So what do you need? Basically, to be successful in mass media research, you should know the basics of research. That's very important. Then secondly, you should know how to use statistics. Okay. Then you should know how to interpret the results. Fourth point that you should know that your research should be verifiable. Whatever research that you have done, if any other X person comes and wants to do the same study, he should verify your research. Your research should be verifiable. And your research should have an objective. You know, there should be objective behind your research. And it should be empirical. What does that mean? It means based on verifiable observation rather than theory or logic. Okay, your research should be cumulative. Why? Because means there should be successive addition to the previous research which is conducted. Okay, that means it should be collective or combined or in totality, right? So whatever research has been done in past, it should add to it. It should be cumulative. And your research has to be logical. It should be based on a clear reasoning, okay? And it should be rational. And, you know, you should always develop a questioning frame of mind always. Every time you develop a question, as I told you previously also, you should always have these questions in front of you. Who, what, where, when, why, and how. So that means five wives and a husband. So it's easy to remember. Okay. So when you are using, you know, all these questions in mass media, you raise a question and you know that this needs to be investigated. So you will, you will be a notch above other researcher in mass media. So always keep this, five wives and a husband in your mind. So you will always have a research question in front of you. All right. Research is used in all areas of mass media. And in this section, particularly, I'm going to talk about electronic media research. All right. So electronic media research, it falls in two categories, basically rating and non-ratings. So the companies which conduct the bulk of, electronic media rating in United States, they are AC Nielsen and Arbitron company, and I have already talked about these two in the previous, you know, slides. So they conduct local market TV and cable TV and radio and you know, these type of research, and they have their own research methodologies, like they publish several texts. It is a very complex method, and they have their own, you know, methods and procedures that should be, you know, they should be consulted for specific information. Now, the data for rating surveys are currently gathered by diaries or electronic meters. As you are aware, each methods have their own advantages and disadvantages. We'll not talk about that here right now, but you can have a lot of information on electronic media rating on internet. Now you can you know, visit the sites of Nielsen and Arbitron also, and also there are other sites as well, like variety.com and adage.com. all right, so you can get all the information on those sites. So in case of non-rating type of you know, electronic media research, it provides information about what the audiences they like and what are their dislikes, and then analyze that you know, different types of programs, then demographics and lifestyle information about the audience. All right, so everything that which falls in that this category will come in the non-rating type of research. Now let's talk more about non-rating research, and some of the procedures of non-rating research, they include you know, program testing. That means research on program ideas, production, final production. All right, now second, commercial testing. It includes testing advertising messages that appear on the TV and radio. Then we come to music research, for example, research based on the opinion of music lovers. So the radio station get the idea of people's choices, and so accordingly they'll play those, and they'll benefit it accordingly. So next is performer quotient, for example, research of various performers and entertainers to know who is more popular. So that is a research which is based on performer Q. Now focus group, research on various focus groups like teachers. Then you are doing research on a group and you are focused, because you are only doing research on teachers, or else you could be students, it could be housewives, then it could be either corporates, for all those preliminary and final research. So you are targeting only focus group in that case. Now another type of, you know, some research procedure could be market studies. So what do we do? To you know, do research on the entire market with the age group of, like, per se 25 to 75 or per 25 to 30 years of age. So you can do that market studies. Format study also can be done. You know, research procedure may include format studies where research based on certain types of format, for example, certain type of music, certain type of, you know, packages. So next is format search studies. Little difference, but a research to find out different available formats in the market for either TV or for radios or for advertisements, etc. Now next is program element importance. It identifies elements on radio and TV that are most important to specific audience. Okay, next is personality talent studies. Research on all the famous personalities who are ruling the TV and cinema and cable and radio. So these are the some research procedures which are done on them. Now account executive research. Research and analysis of all the local and national sales representative with advertising. This you know, it helps the company to hire them for their benefit. Okay, now sales research, why it is done? As the name suggests, it is to know how the sales have been, you know, to have been, and how to, you know, prepare and then advertise and proposal for the clients, etc. Now, print. Many types of research are conducted by print media, and these research are used and have gained attention by wide variety of clients. Okay, now 14th point is readership. It includes research in the reader profiles, item selection studies, then reader non-reader studies, gratification studies, editor reader comparison, etc. Circulation, in this, you know, research on who reads the newspaper, who reads a particular magazine, to understand basically how the circulation can be increased, or what the reader wants to have, you know, included in the newspaper or magazine. Then management research, research in on goal setting by management, research on employee job satisfaction, research on effect of competitions, typography and makeup. Here, you know, research on effect of newspaper design. See, sometime, you know, the way you present your material, that also have an impact on sales. So research on the effect of newspaper design, newspaper room, newspaper makeup, page makeup, type or font that is used. These all have their effect on readership and their preferences. So you can do a research on that also. Then readability, research on the elements that affect the success of a piece of printed material. Some are hot topic, they sell like hot cakes, so you have to do a research on that also. Now, online media usage, research related to the internet and how it affects a newspaper and magazine, that can be a topic of research. So these are the research procedure, different research procedure that you can do. Some can be done on internet also. So online research, this can come in this category. Research in advertising and public relations, they include various topics like copy testing, means effectiveness of the advertising. Then reach and frequency, they do research on how many people have been reached by this such and such advertising, how many ads in a day gives the best result, example, which frequency is best. Okay, now internet based research, how internet is affecting advertising and public relation. Then campaign assessment is also done. Okay, fair research is done on success of a running advertising campaign. Okay, then public relation, now introspective research to investigate certain issues is done. Now social audit, where monitoring a program to know how well a company is living up to its social responsibility, that can come in a social audit. Okay, and then you also have evaluation research, where research to judge the effectiveness of a program. Okay, and its implementation and impact. So these all come, the research in advertising and public relation include all these topics. See, internet has you know, quickly become a mass media. It has enormous or countless number of research possibility for mass media researchers. For example, online research, you can see this everywhere, every time, wherever you unknowingly, knowingly answer the internet based questionnaires. So online research, you always participate, whether you know it or no, whether you want it or no. Sometimes just by your browsing history, they, you know, get to know your answers. So second is website results. So what makes a good website, how to attract people to your website, ask what else do they want on your, want to see on your website. So these are also internet based researches. Now music testing, for example, radio station, they test short segments of you know, songs, and they, you know, put it on a internet, and these are called hooks, you know, to test the public interest. So music testing is also done on internet. Now advertising testing is also done. People on the net provide their reaction to advertising, whether they see the advertising on social you know, radio, TV or print media on the internet. So to conclude, mass media is a commercial industry, and it's primary or basic motive is to get profit related to sales or audience, and mass media research helps them to attain that goal. Okay, it involves three steps: what people want, then provide it to them, and not only provide it to them, you have to tell them it is that you have given it to them. Then only you will, you know, they will value you. If you just provide it to them, they will not know who is giving it to them. They'll not come back to you. You want them, you know, for sales, for them to come back to you, you have to tell them that you are providing this information or this thing to them, which is valuable to them. So researchers help find what people want, also what is the best way to give it, and the best way to advertise the same. So research is included in every step. Researchers help in decision making. Research is an integral part of mass media, because research gives us the best result and it gives us, you know, capacity to make better decisions. Thank you for watching this, and in our next lecture I'm going to cover scope of mass media and the role of research in the media. Thank you and have a good day.